In this video, I'm going to demonstrate some basic sketch projection and how it's going to apply here in this particular scenario. So, in this model, it's going to be for a transformer figure I'm working on. I have these two pieces that are going to be basically cowl pieces either side of the head, represented by the cylinder, and they're also going to lock in an arm that's going to attach here via this combiner port, like we have in the Combiner Wars figures. So I already have my holes here for plugging in the cowl pieces on each side, but I need to put pegs down the bottom to put in these holes. So what I'm going to do is project the profiles of these holes into the bottom of these cowl pieces. So in order to do that, I'm going to create a new sketch on the bottom here. Oops, now you see I have all this other junk here in the way, so I'm gonna make this all disappear. Okay, I actually need the torso back. There we go. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go up here under Create and go all the way down here where it says Project and Include. I'll click on Project, just like that. And the geometry I want are these lines here. And actually, if you see me highlight the points and the sides of my hexagonal hole, you can actually see them up here, kind of highlighting like where they're going to project. And that happens with any of the geometry here. Yeah, it can get kind of interesting. So, but what I want are these basically my the edges of my holes to project up there. I guess if I really wanted to too, I could just project this whole thing. I don't want to. All I just want are the holes. I'm okay with just clicking on them. I guess it's a little therapeutic, I suppose. I don't know. Okay. So I clicked on all those. If I flip this down over here and zoom in a little bit, you can see the purple outlines of what is being projected. This selection filter here, you can choose whether it's bodies or specified entities. I just leave that specified entities and projection link. I always leave that checked. I believe what that does is that if the original thing that's being projected changes, that whatever is affected by that up here is also going to change. So I'm going to leave that checked. I'll click OK. And there we go. I've got my projected hexagons. Now, the reason that I made hexagonal holes instead of circular holes is there's a thought that by having hexagonal holes and open corners around like a circular peg, it keeps the hole from developing a vacuum on the peg. So if there's a vacuum on that peg, it's going to be harder to pull it out. So the hexagonal holes are supposed to prevent that by having openings around the peg. So that means that this is basically a circumscribed shape, if I recall correctly. Circumscribed being that the circle touches the flat sides of the polygon, whereas an inscribed shape, you have the corners of the polygon touching the inside of a circle. So these are circumscribed here. Alright, so now I want to actually make my holes. So I'm going to make this torso disappear here and get to the bottom of this, literally. And I'm just going to make 5mm holes. Now, as you might recall, these holes, there's usually hole shrinkage going from CAD to the 3D printer. So it's important to design for that in CAD, which I already have. I've actually never tried to compensate for polygon holes. I'm assuming that they're going to have the same shrinkage issues as circular holes, so I'm adding like a half millimeter tolerance or so. I'm making my hexagonal holes about a half millimeter, maybe 0.6 millimeters bigger than I guess you'd really want to specify, but that's so they print right. So there we go. I've got my hexagonal holes, I've got my circular pegs profiles centered in the hexagonal holes. So now I'll finish sketch and make my pegs. So extrude. Select them all to extrude. I want to make these 5 millimeters long. There we go. Now let's bring their torso back. Now you see how these are supposed to line up here. I'll just highlight the two bodies and move them. Now it's not just, I really think you need to print these, or at least print some kind of a test to see if these are actually going to fit together. But you can see that by moving them close to each other like this, you can see how they basically align. There, mission accomplished. And I hope that when I finally print this will work as intended, and these will stay in there solidly while being able to come out when I want them to. So that's one use for projecting geometry. Just to help align things different between part, just to help align things better between parts. Thank you for watching this video. If you liked it, please be sure to click the like and subscribe buttons below. Also, post any questions you have in the comments and I may answer them in another video. And remember, anyone who stops learning is old, whether at 20 or 80. Anyone who keeps learning stays young. So keep learning, keep designing, keep making, and be proud of your work.